Hey guys, Accountability Angel here, and we're back outside the Streator, Illinois Police Department. It's November 3rd, 2021, a little bit after 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I came to this same department back on August 2nd, 2021, and their call phone did not work, their intercom did not work, and even when I found people, they treated me poorly. Their city manager, I believe his name is Dave Plyman, maybe, told me I was a joke for coming to inquire about a complaint. I did not see Dave's car over there, but we'll see. And it was, if you guys notice, business hours up there. It was within business hours in the middle of the day on like a Tuesday or something. Actually, let me see if it's open. Oh, it is open this time. I wonder if the phone works. I'm gonna check it. It did not have a dial tone at all last time. They tried to tell me I was lying. Oh, it does have a dial tone. I don't know if you guys can hear it. Glad that works this time. The blue line flag. No gun locks. Maybe that means everybody's locking their gun.
Hello, can I help you?
Yeah, I needed to speak to somebody about inquiring how to file a complaint. I'm like an officer.
So I'm here at the police station. This is the records.
Uh-huh.
You get the dispatch, you just pick up this phone. Don't have to dial, dispatch will pick it up. Tell them what you're here for, and then I'll have an officer come in. We can't dispatch from records, because our dispatch is actually combined with another dispatch.
Okay.
So that's what you have to
do. So just pick up that black phone?
Don't dial. Dispatch, it might take a second or two, but dispatch will pick it up, tell them what you're here for, and they'll ask you a couple questions.
Okay, great. Right? Thank you. Hello, I'm at the police department in Streator, and I was trying to speak to somebody about how I file an officer complaint. I didn't want to give my name. I do not have to give my name to file a complaint, ma'am. No, are you an officer? Well, they can ask me all they want, but per the Illinois state law, I do not have to identify. All right, thank you. Well, she was rude. She told me that I did have to identify. I got another one there. No wonder they're tyrants. Except for this guy, he seemed okay so far. Sir?
Yeah.
Do you know who's in charge of collecting the drugs from the drop box for the drugs?
We do quite a bit.
Oh, just you guys?
Yeah, just the records, and then they take it somewhere and destroy them.
Oh, how do they have systems in place, like not saying you would, but if somebody were having a pill problem and they saw some Norcos in there and pocketed them.
I don't think they can get into it. It's like a mailbox, like it drops into a spot.
But I mean like maybe you or like somebody here, not saying you would, but do they have like systems in place to like, are two people there when they do it?
There's usually two of us in here that do it together.
Oh, okay. I was curious how it worked just in case, because, you know, nobody's safe from addiction.
You're right. You're right. Was that phone out there in the yellow box working when you picked it up?
It did work this time. I actually checked it because last time I was here, it was just dead.
We were having some issues with it, and I didn't know if they got it fixed yet.
They tried to tell me I was lying last time, and I was like, dude, go check it yourself. The intercom didn't work either.
Yeah.
I don't know what that does now. I'm going to check it, though.
Yeah, if it ain't working, that's why I asked you. I had to tell somebody if it's not working because it should be working now.
Yeah, perfect.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm going to wait out here for him. I'm going to go inspect some cars. I think. You think they'd have some cameras over in the parking lot? I don't see any. Oh. Forgot to bring my sparkly pen. Watch them, they'll do that crap where I can't use a publicly funded pen. Although last time I assumed it was publicly funded. It actually was not, and it was actually, I believe it was an insurance group from somewhere near Sandwich. And obviously they use those pens to, you know, advertise and such, but I don't think they wanted their pens to be used to abuse the citizens when they're trying to inquire about filing complaints. I haven't found any laptops open yet, though, so that's good. I wonder how long they'll hold me up. They're known for holding me up. That dispatcher was so rude. Number one, even if she were to be right, which she was wrong, you do not have to identify. Even if she was right, why speak in such a condescending tone? I wish they had a speaker so I could have recorded it. I tried to get it close. We do have an open laptop in the squad. What squad is that? Well, kind of janky plate is that? I didn't realize that was the M at first in the beginning. Well, let's see. The records guy was very kind so far. Oh, great. I see a squad coming up. I wonder if he's for me. I do have to say, I love the police trucks. Oh, no. That is another open laptop. I don't know what he's pointing at. He's trying to pull there. Let's see if he's who's helping me or not. Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Complaints?
Yeah, are you the one that's supposed to help me?
I'm supposed to help you.
What's your name, sir?
Osborn.
Well, I came here way back in August, and the phone didn't work, and then the little intercom thing didn't work, and I couldn't get service at all, right?
That site over there.
Well, nobody's around, so I tried it.
We don't use that. That's all shit. That's where our office used to
be. Yeah, it was like the middle of the day, too. I waited for, like, hours, and then the only person that would give me any service was the city manager, Dave Plyman, and he comes out, and instead of treating me with respect and finding out the complaint, what it may or may not be, he tells me what a joke I am and all this, and refused to give me like a real officer trying to act like he could do that. I don't know. But anyway, I just wanted to inquire about the complaint process and how I go about doing that, and how you guys think I should handle complaining on Dave Plyman, but for him acting as a police officer that day, because he did and I filmed it.
I can give you a written statement.
Mm-hmm.
A statement. Fill it out. If you have a concern with him, you can put that in that. Chief of police will look into it. Okay.
See, and that was another thing. I called and left a few voicemails. I spoke with a nighttime sergeant. I can't think of his name right now, and he was very kind and everything, but after that, I couldn't get anybody to respond, and it's just like, is this normal abuse here?
So is this a complaint against an officer or against the city manager?
Well, he was acting as an officer, and that he literally refused to get me a real officer and said I had to deal with him.
I mean, I can get you a statement, okay, but if you have a complaint against the city manager, my best advice for you, come to the next city council meeting.
Well, yes.
And I can tell you when the next city council meeting is after I ask, because I don't know when the city council meetings are.
Yeah, do you see why I want to complain to the police, though? Because he was acting as if he were you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I didn't care for that, because by the end of it, he's calling me a joke and locking the door, kicking me out.
Go to the city council meeting and go to the state's attorney's office.
Okay.
And I know you had some problems there also. Or that was the sheriff's office, state's attorney's office.
They are going down. You just wait to
that's
see.
That's in the same building, but talk to the state's attorney's office about it, too.
Last time I went there, they threatened me with arrest for standing there conducting business.
That was the sheriff's office.
In the state's attorney's office.
In the same building, okay? Yeah. Or set up a meeting with the assistant state's attorney.
I have made many attempts, let me tell you. It's been an ongoing process. You'll see how that ends. You will see. But I guess you know who I am then. So I was asking the dispatcher when I was talking to her on the phone. She asked my name, and I said, well, I didn't want to give it. And then she says, no, you have to give it. And I said, no, you're wrong. But I do not in Illinois have to identify if I want to just file a complaint on a police officer. Is that correct?
Thing is, if you're going to file a complaint against an officer or a city employee, my sergeant, my chief, my state's attorney's office, has got to know who they're talking to when they contact you back.
Well, the thing is, though, like, if you're out, you know, hooking up with prostitutes on the job, right? Just saying. And then I say, hey, I saw this guy doing all this, but I want to stay out of it. Then I have every right to do so. I get that it would make things more complicated.
Mm-hmm.
I understand that. But by law, I don't have to.
Right.
Correct?
And you need to understand that my dispatch is no longer here. I am dispatched out of Pontiac, Illinois.
Yeah, that's what they were telling me in there.
Yeah, and that's where that yellow phone goes to.
Uh-huh.
Or if you walk through that door is unlocked now.
Yeah.
Okay, it was locked before because of the cold. There's a phone inside there that you pick up that will send you right to Livingston County.
Yeah, that's what they had me do. So, when you guys receive the complaints, how exactly does it work? Do they actually contact you back if you give them contact information? Because I've ran into that before.
My sergeant or my chief will contact you back and say, hey, what's going on?
Who should I contact if they refuse to? The mayor? Or... because that's what I've run into. I mean, I came here, honestly, just to do a compliance check because the sheriff's office started that. That's when I realized there was an issue. And then when I came here, the phones didn't work, which I get, you know, needs to be taken care of. But then I was treated so poorly.
Did you pick up the phone today?
Yeah, it worked. It worked.
Okay.
Yeah, I picked up both phones, so they worked fine. But I just wanted to know the process, get a form, and complain on Plyman, however best situates, because it's kind of, you know, he kind of tangled it in as he wanted to act as a police officer when I was demanding to see a real one.
I will give you a statement form, okay?
Yeah, because you never know what somebody has done to somebody.
You fill it out. I'll show you what to fill out, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'll do a quick little report. I'll send it to the state's attorney's office.
Okay. Well, it's not like a criminal complaint. It's not what I'm looking for.
Well, no. I'm going to give you a voluntary statement.
Yeah.
Okay?
So why would it go to the state's... I guess that's where I'm getting confused.
To see if the state's attorney wants me to pursue this any further for going after him for being a police officer. I have not watched that video, okay? I don't know what it's about.
Yeah, he didn't necessarily, like, try to identify as one. He was refusing to give me somebody and said that he can act on behalf of you guys or whatever. You know what I mean? Yeah, I wouldn't say he was trying to...
He can't because roundabout, he's my boss.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
The chief is my boss. The city manager is the chief's boss.
Yep.
So he's a top echelon.
Yeah, no, I get you. So, that's why I didn't know exactly what.
I can give you a voluntary statement form if you want to fill it out. You can either fill it out now or you can bring it back. I'm off at 2 o'clock today. I will be back tomorrow, 6 to 2.
Okay.
If I'm not here, come outside.
All right, perfect.
I'll show you where to put it.
Yeah, you know, I don't come to these places trying to start issues. I come just doing my business. And since all that stuff with the sheriff's office, that's when I decided I need to check out other people's complaint processes.
Do you have any?
I do not. I have a medical exemption. They already let me in, though, if it makes you feel better.
So if you bring back my statement form, okay,
uh-huh.
You can pick that up and say, hey, I have a voluntary statement for Osborn. I need to drop it off.
Okay.
Or the very first window here.
To that guy?
No. They'll be gone. They leave at 5 o'clock, 4:30. Okay.
Uh-huh.
This window over here. There's a little slot there. Just slide that statement for him.
Oh, on that one? Okay.
Nobody is here. Okay. Uh-huh. Get that phone or that phone.
Okay.
If nobody comes here and you're in a hurry, just slide my statement underneath here.
Okay.
And send me a report in my mailbox and I'll get it tomorrow morning.
Perfect. Now, will that count as the internal complaint as well or no? Or how should I?
As far as what?
I want to internally complain on Plyman for acting as a police officer and refusing me service and calling me a joke when I was trying to inquire about a complaint.
Let's go outside here.
You see where it gets sticky? I wasn't exactly. It took me a while to come back, but I knew
like
today
I said,
was the day.
You fill out the statement for me, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I know who you are, okay? But please fill it out. This way my sergeant will read my report. He'll contact you back if it's a credible complaint, okay, then we'll follow through. We'll call the state's attorney's office, say, hey, this is what we got going on.
Yeah, it was, but now...
Recommendations for us. I mean, but like you said, it's not criminal the way he was supposedly talking to you.
Yeah, I don't believe it was, but
okay.
Then again...
I mean, so state's attorney's office may tell me to take care of it yourself, and my best advice for the next city council meeting.
Yeah, I want the damn police chief to be like, hey, man, don't do that to one of... I could have very well been a victim of a serious crime and you guys not known it yet. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been in that position and I've been treated great and I've been treated poorly. And that's why I'm... That's why I came.
Still doing this.
You know what I mean? That's why I got started. I was illegally detained for no reason.
But like I said, I mean, if it's not criminal, I mean, mm-hmm. I can't go after him and press charges against him.
No, I understand.
My best advice would be the next city council meeting and voice your concern with... They'll be there, and then everybody on the city council.
Now, will, if I walk over to, like, the mayor's office, will the mayor accept, like, a written complaint on this guy? Or it seems so hard to hold certain people accountable, you know?
I don't know what they do upstairs, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't know what City Hall does as far as complaints and stuff like that. I've been doing this for 16 years, so I know complaints for us are done down here. I don't know as far as other city employees.
No, I gotcha. That makes sense.
I wish I could help you out with that question.
Yeah, I'm going over there. He doesn't realize I don't give up. You don't treat me wrong.
And I don't even know if the mayor's here. My best advice on that situation, just schedule an appointment with the mayor.
Yeah, because sadly, that Dave Plyman, I checked it out. He's like the highest paid person in this whole damn town. Over $100,000 a year to treat me like that. With his benefits, it was almost $200,000. It was crazy. But yeah, I'll definitely take the form and do whatever. I'll get him. Thank you. I'll just chill here. It's cool. Well, Osborn knew exactly who I was. I am wearing glasses today. I was gonna, I went as Alice in Wonderland for Halloween. So I planned to like put on my blonde ass, obviously fake wig and do some audits that way just for funsies. So we'll see, but I will say Osborn has been nothing but professional and kind to me and trying to steer me in the right way. Obviously, I already knew the state's attorney's office ain't gonna do nothing. They hate me. They don't have a right to hate me. They really don't they don't have a reason, I guess is more my word. Because I've done nothing wrong. Like, yeah, I'll call you 5 times a week. If you're gonna take months and months and months after I was battered to ever say anything and then still not say anything. Still. Like, it's crazy. But yeah, Osborn has done a pretty good job so far. I'm proud of him. Actually, I had literally anxiety in my other audit just because of the way I was treated so poorly here last time. And you guys will see that in my library video. Like, it was starting to hit me.
You didn't think I was coming back, did you?
No, I was actually telling everybody how great you've been so far.
You're all nice, okay? I mean, you're every now.
Hey, you know, there's some people even at the sheriff's office that I think are pretty decent people, and I'm actually proud that their lieutenant got the hell out of there, because he was one of the only decent ones I met. I mean, I think there's just a way to treat people, and you never know what they're going through. Just like how if I came in here, I mean, I could act a totally different way when I conduct my audits and just be an asshole to you the second you guys come up. But I try not to.
If you want respect, you should respect.
Yeah. Hey, I generally do. All right.
No, I'm not here. Nobody's here. Like I said, slide underneath the window.
Okay.
I'll get it when I come back in.
And I do not have to identify, but it's helpful if I do. Is that correct?
Yes.
Alright.
So we know who we're talking to, when the sergeant or the chief or somebody calls you back.
Now, if I want to send, like... I know, I hate it.
Back to that thing.
Yeah, this but way, sometimes you are afraid because, you know, when I turned in a complaint form before, I was falsely arrested outside of a building.
When I'm calling the phone number, say, hey, is female there? Can I talk to the female?
Yeah, you got a point. No, I totally get why it's a good thing to do so, but I like to make sure everybody understands you don't have to. You know what I mean? But it is good to make sure the citizens are aware that it does complicate things.
So I have
things.
To give you my name, huh?
Absolutely. You're on the public dime, homie.
City Council meeting, third Wednesday of the month, 7 p.m.
Oh, perfect. Thank you. So I appreciate you.
When you're done, date it, sign it. I'll sign there as a witness. And if you can, just fill out that for me. Okay.
Fine.
And I'll fill out the rest.
Fine, fine. I'm not telling them where I work, though. They'll come in and try to dox my address for no reason, even.
Well, you have to leave me a home number, a phone number that my sergeant can call you back.
No, I will. So, if I have videos to go along with it, because I was just filming, and then because of the treatment, I went live and had a big audience watching. But, can I email that? How should I wait till they contact me? Because then they always tell me that, and then nobody contacts me.
Let's see what's going on. Because, like I said, it's not criminal.
Yeah. No, I mean for the internal part. Because
as far as like the city stuff.
Yeah, because I feel like your police chief should have a problem with somebody behaving that way on behalf of his department. Does that make sense?
I don't understand. I don't know when all this happened.
August 2nd.
This year?
Yeah. Yep. I was treated so poorly. I was just telling my camera how I was nervous. I just left the library and stuff. And I felt the anxiety going over me because I knew I was coming here and I knew I might be treated like shit again.
And I calmed you.
And luckily you didn't. Yeah, you treated me kindly. But, all right.
Fill that out. Bring it back up to me. Like I said, I'm off at 2 today, 6 to 2 tomorrow, and probably 2 a.m. Sunday.
Perfect. So, all right, sounds good.
I'll start something up for you.
All right, thank you. I appreciate your help, Osborn.
Have a good day.
You get home safe tonight.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
Yep. All right, guys. I have nothing but good things to say overall about Osborn. Solid pass for him. Totally understand the position of most of the guys I'm crying about today are over him, so that sucks. But, nonetheless, I'd call this a good day for Streator, honestly. I mean, it's gone pretty well. So all we ask for is be treated with respect. I mean, you don't always want to identify. I totally get that it does make things harder, but you don't always want to identify, especially depending on what's going on, what's happened. I mean, me, I don't really care. I just like to see what they say. Just for other people's references. So... All right, guys, well, solid pass for Streator Police Department. Congratulations to Osborn for being the one to change things around. And, you know, even just that small interaction, it gives you a little bit better of a view on them. Just a little bit, though. Very upset with the way I was treated last time. Look how cool that is. But anyway, guys, all right, that's it for today. I will shortly be going inside City Hall. Thanks for watching. Tell your friends. Congrats, Osborn and Streator PD. Can't believe I'm even saying that at this point. All right, guys. Bye.